Hey, sup, name's Thomas. I'm gonna tell you a funny little story about how me and a couple of my friends actually saved our home from completely falling apart. Without further ado, here's the story. Gordon, what the fuck? Now, despite that incredibly awesome intro, that's not where our story begins. No, our story begins into a place you actually might expect. Be honest, where else were you expecting? anyway. Well, where our story really begins is, well, one day, Stanley was getting held up by Karen Coach. I mean, a very impolite coach. Come on, you've been making me wait for 45 minutes. These folks need to get to Wellsworth.
Well, excuse me. I need to look absolutely perfect.
Not like you and Jin could understand anything about looking good.
Hey, that was unnecessary! Ugh, Henry, come on, man, help me out here.
Man, what the fuck do you want from me? I can't do much. Jin, please help.
Sorry, Stanley. Wish I could help, but this bitch-ass piece of firewood won't shut the fuck up. And I don't know how to shut up that piece of fucking firewood, okay?
Oi! Box tanks! I'm not firewood!
What are you getting snappy about? Now you're snapping at me? What the fuck, bitch?
Both of you, shut it! I'm not having another one of your arguments. Especially, you know, if it has to get violent. I don't want to be involved.
Still, I wish I could help, but I don't know how to shut up a Karen coach.
Fine, guess I'll wait here for eternity then.
What's the rush anyway, you stupid American?
It's, you know what? Where my base comes from, that's not important. What is important is, oh, I don't know. We're just packed to the brim with celebrities and you've been holding them up for the last 45 minutes?
What? Why didn't you say anything? Let's get going!
Alright, I'm going, jeez.
Yeah, see you, Stanley.
Well, little did any of us actually know that was going to be the last time any of us, I mean any of us, would actually ever see Stanley again. And apparently, some dumb fuck of a signalman ended up sending Stanley down my branch line, but I'm getting angry. Let's get back to the story. If you don't mind me asking, what exactly is your name again?
Fiona.
And of course you're still mad at me. Why am I not surprised? Wait a tick. I don't think we're supposed to be here.
Well, now you notice!
Well, won't you look at that? There's a station. Maybe someone can help us. Huh, that's a bit strange. Nobody's here. Well, Fiona, how about you sit tight? I'm gonna go try to find some help. And I can guarantee you this, I'll be back as fast as I can.
Of course he left me here. He'll be back anyway. Right?
Ha, got you. That was the only context of the story. Now, let's really begin the story.
Thomas, hey, come on, sleepy smoke box, wake up, it's important.
For God's sake, you made me do this. Good lordy! Jesus Christ, Percy, you scared the shit out of me!
Well, excuse me, I was just trying to tell you that the Fat Controller wants us to meet him and the other engines at Nafford Station, and I was just trying to wake you up.
Wow, you changed your tune kind of quick.
Well, anyway, that doesn't matter now. Come, my green friend. We have a whole station full of engines waiting for us.
Yeah, hey, as fun as that sounds, can a tram engine get some damn sleep around here?
Sorry, Toby.
Sorry, Toby.
Yeah, let's get going.
And, well, right then and there, the two of us went off to go to Nafford, not knowing what was awaiting us. Jeez, you dragging out a scene much?
That's a bit strange. Why is Jinty there?
I honestly have no clue. The faintest I can remember is he was muttering about being guilty about something.
Huh. It's kind of weird for him to feel guilty about something.
Forget it. We'll ask when we actually get there.
And Jesus Christ, Percy wasn't kidding. Almost everyone was there.
What is taking those little bugs so long?
Oh, come on, James. Have a little patience.
Exactly, my dear engine. Patience is a virtue, truly.
Well, since we could be waiting for a while, I think we should... never mind then.
Well, it's about time.
What's going on here? Why is everyone else here?
My question's exactly, Thomas. So, sir, mind explaining why we're all here?
Yes, thank you, Edward. Now that I have all of your attention, well, I need to put this briefly. Unfortunately, I regret to inform that, well, Stanley has seemed to vanish into thin air.
Wait,
what? Excuse me, sir?
Excuse me, sir? Plainly just horrible.
Sir, you must be joking.
Unfortunately not, Edward. Believe me, like the rest of you, I want to believe that's not true. Fortunately, he never came back with his train. And as we checked down Thomas's branch line...
Wait, hold on. Why was he on my branch line?
Irresponsible signalman.
Had a feeling.
Okay, listen, faulty signalman or not, it's not important anymore. What is important is, if you find or see any trace of Stanley, please come to see me immediately. Now, I highly suggest everyone go talk to Machete about this discussion. I have a lot of paperwork to sign out. Thank you for listening.
Oh, please. It's impossible for an engine to up and vanish.
Hey, James, have you ever heard of suspension of disbelief?
Oh, you wanna go, fish boy?
Yeah, come on, right here, right now, in front of everybody, I'll kick your fucking ass.
Quiet, the both of you.
Sorry, Edward.
Yeah, sorry, Edward.
Good. Now, Gordon, do you have anything to add before we go?
Okay, then it's settled then. We'll talk about this at Tidman. For now, I have an express train in 2 hours, and now I need to get some rest.
Thomas, Percy, what about the both of you?
Me, Percy, and Toby might want to go discuss this at Farquhar Sheds.
Yeah, it'll probably be better that way, so that way we're not in the way of anything. Now, any objections?
No. Not at all, Edward.
Good. And I think I might know the engine that we can talk to about this whole situation.
And that's why you called me here?
Essentially, yes. I assumed, since you're kind of one of the main researchers of this island, I had a feeling you would know something about this.
Yeah, like a vault, I had a feeling this would come back to haunt us eventually.
Eh? What come back to haunt us exactly?
Well, Donald, I'm glad you asked. It's rumored that there's a special coach somewhere on this island, hidden away, usually as a backup key. And considering the first signs of the magic falling apart is engines vanishing and some parts of the island deteriorating, I wouldn't pick a better time than now to try and find it. If it's real, that is.
Wait. Okay, listen here, Chuckle Tracks. You expect me to start believing that a bunch of engines are now starting to disappear due to some magical engine going away? You expect me to believe that?
Not with that little smooth brain up there in that smoke box.
Alright, that was funny, but very unnecessary, Oliver.
I mean, it's true, Henry. You usually never have the smoothest smoke box of this group.
Okay, seriously, back on topic. Oliver, do you know if there's any way we can find this coach?
Well, the legend does say only 3 brave enough adventurers can find it if they know where to look.
I think I might know a couple of engines.
Wait, hang on. So you're saying me, Percy, and James have to go and find a magic coach to save this whole island from falling apart?
What, you're gonna go against Oliver's word all of a sudden?
No, not at all. I mean, well, we'll do it. How much are we getting paid?
Thomas, you're not getting paid. You're literally saving our entire home.
Yeah, I know. It was just a trick question.
Thomas, I think you're forgetting James isn't so convinced easily when it comes to this kind of adventurous stuff.
Oh yeah, I forgot how stubborn that engine is. Oh yeah, good point. Don't worry, Edward. I'll talk to him later tonight, alright?
Thank you, Thomas. I know you know how to, well, deal with James's arrogance.
No problem, old iron. Meanwhile...
What? But, Diesel, what are you doing out in the main line?
None of your damn business, Montague.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sure.
Later that night, because I'm bad at transitions...
Later that night, I finally decided to discuss with James about what we were going to do.
Alright, Thomas, so what did you want to talk about exactly?
So, you see, well, I had this whole idea set up where you, me, and Percy can go to the scrapyard, go find whatever we need to, and restore Sodor once and forever.
Alright, yeah, that's fine. Hang on, wait a second! You expect me, the most splendid thing on Sodor, to go right ahead with you two and get dirty black smudges all over this beautiful red paint?
I will throw in a couple cans of red paint if you accept.
Okay, fine, we'll give in the morning.
Ah, that's the spirit, my good friend.
But now...
I think we might need to get some shut-eye. I couldn't agree with you more. We've got a busy day ahead of us.
Indeed, James. Indeed.
But little did we know, there was something much darker going on.
Well, about time you showed up.
Oh, shut the fuck up, Dodge.
Hey, Bert, look, it's Mr. Oily!
Shut the hell up, you goddamn lemonhead.
Apologies for being late. Sneaking around this island isn't the easiest task.
I'm just glad you could finally make it.
As far as I've heard, this is the exact Diesel from 2000.
Yep. Pulled out of the barge and restoring him since 2000.
That's good to hear. I'm just wondering when he'll actually be out.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you all the Napoleon of Crime himself, Diesel 10! Come on out, big guy!
Holy shit!
I will admit the only flaw is, well, he is kind of a mute.
You're saying that like I care. Welcome back!
Well, how about we go take a throne that is respectfully ours?
The next morning, we were officially ready to go.
Alright, you two, you officially ready to hit the ironworks?
I guess so.
Yep, couldn't be more ready. Hang on a damn second. How do you know we're supposed to be going to the ironworks? No one ever told us.
To be dead honest with you, I think I'm just gonna be guessing that a lot. Anyways, I'm getting off track. Come on, let's get going.
Well, as they say, life is a highway after all.
Broken door, where blues won't haunt you anymore. Where the brave are free and lovers soar. Come ride with me to the distant shore. We won't hesitate to break down the garden gate. There's not much time left today.
I know you might suffer a lot of trials and tribulations down this journey, but don't think about quitting for a minute. I know you three can accomplish so much, even if it has to come down to this hole. Don't worry, you'll always have me by your side. You three are truly going to have the time of your lives.
Wait. Okay, I'm sorry, but if we keep playing that, we're going to get in some serious copyright trouble, so we're just going to have to cut later. We can? Okay. Again, very sorry, but copyright law, so alright. Later, halfway across Sodor, me, James, and Percy decided to stop to talk to someone to see if we could get any more information about the clue. Alright, gang, we're finally and wait a minute! Where the hell's James?
Oh, here he comes.
You could have at least waited up a little bit.
Well, right now, that's not really the most important issue. What is an important issue is...
Actually, that's another thing. Why are we even here to begin with? Shouldn't we be, saving an island?
Actually, I'm very glad you asked, because I was just getting to that.
Oh, Merlin!
What was that for? Nothing even happened.
Here he comes.
Hey, I'm just out here gonna ask politely, maybe could you please keep the noise down? I'm just trying to sleep.
Now that's what I call a dramatic entrance!
Thank you, Thomas. I do try my best. Now, what brings you and your friends here?
Actually, yeah. We were wondering if you had any, more context on a clue about a magic coach or something?
I think I remember a rhyme that went along with the clue. On your trip down the main line, if you look hard enough, and you'll find a little old coach that's been left behind. Or at least I think that's how the rhyme went.
Wow. Well then, that had to be the stupidest, fakest bullshit I have ever heard.
James, dude, come on, man, be a little respectful.
Oh, really now? You're just gonna blindly believe all of that?
Oh boy, here we go again.
Listen, I don't really now. Care you're gonna what try you're to prove right that. Now,
but oh, you're just all smart and shit. Besides, I'm going really?
Well, are they usually always like this?
Yeah, basically all the time. I'm so sorry you have to witness all this.
Talking about,
you don't even think about going there, you red tomato to piece the girl.
Wow! Alright, you know what? You, zip it! We have somewhere to be now, come on!
The nerve of that engine sometimes!
But on another note, it was nice to catch up with you, Merlin. Same with you, James. Have a nice travel. Those engines are quite interesting, aren't they, Hank?
Hank? Hank, you okay?
Turns out while we were on our little adventure, looks like Edward was about to, start his own. Gordon, who's that little maroon tank engine over there?
Oh. Him? He's Arthur. He's been here since 2003.
That's interesting. Wait, hang on. You're telling me this engine's been here for about almost a decade now, and you guys never bothered to tell me of his existence?
That didn't really come to mind.
Of course. Wait, hang on. What the hell? You know what? I'm gonna go finally talk some sense into those little yellow fuckers.
Edward, come on. You know it's useless to try to reason with those two lemon heads.
You shut the hell up. It is my life, and I'll live it however I want to.
Ha, it's your funeral.
Oi, Bert. Who do we have here, then?
I think it's old Cherry Boy.
Oh, come on, guys. That name is really... demeaning.
Oh, for God's sake, Bert, does it look like we even slightly give a shit?
No, we don't. And trust me, if we did, I think we'd lose the whole point of us existing because we give a shit.
Big fucking Zachly. Oh, for God's sake, what do you want, Bluey?
Hello, you two. I'm just... I have a little question. Would you mind leaving this little engine alone before you really get me pissed off?
Oh, so scary!
Ooh, I'm so intimidated. Bitch, please, we could literally throw you into the ironworks faster than you could even say with a huff and a puff.
That's kind of funny, because I think I can shove you both in that key and leave you to rust! You get the picture?
Bert, let's get the hell out of here.
Yeah, let's go. Let's get the hell out of here, Bert. Oh, wait, I'm Bert. God damn it. Ugh.
Finally, thought those two would never leave.
Well, that certainly happened.
Oh, forgive me. I'm Edward. You must be Arthur.
Yep, sir, that's me, and I really couldn't thank you enough for all that.
No problem at all. How about we go on my branch line and chat a little bit, get to know each other?
Sounds fun. Edward? Is that your name?
Yep, that would be me. Come on, let's get going.
Well, meanwhile, back with us.
Alright then, finally, here we are. Our options are we can just go to Kildane to go to Kirk Ronan, or we could go down the other way towards the Ironworks.
Well, I want to be safe to say our best bet is Kirk Ronan. I don't think it's safe for us engines to go snooping around in the Ironworks for a coach.
Well, sorry to disagree with you, James, but I may have to say the Ironworks, considering you know who is waiting at Kirk Ronan at all times, and will completely beat up- No, wait, Percy, I'm sorry, but James has a point. Come on, man, have some sense.
Have some sense? Fucking excuse me?
Seriously, Percy, just consider, we could be a lot safer going down there than risk, you know, being burnt alive in the Ironworks.
See? There's my point exactly.
Seriously, I'm just trying to warn you here.
No, that's enough arguing. We're going to Kirk Ronan. Now, are you in or out?
No, you know what? If you guys get yourself beat, just don't say I didn't warn you.
What's his problem?
He's probably just upset considering we didn't go along with his stupid plan. Come on, we've got an island to save.
Jesus, the nerves of those two. I swear they have no idea what's coming to them at Kirk.
Wait, hang on. Thomas and James are going to Kirk? But don't they know that-
Yeah, I know. Trust me, I tried to warn them, but I couldn't get through them, so I'm gonna just let those idiots get what they deserve for not listening.
What was Percy talking about? We're absolutely fine.
Yo, Thomas. Thomas!
Okay, you're never usually this quiet. What the hell's up with you?
You might want to look in front of us.
Oh, calm down. What could be the problem? Oh, we're so fucked.
You boys have got about 5 seconds before I have 98462 here beat the ever-loving shit out of you for trespassing without a job.
We're gonna sit back and take it, aren't we?
We're just gonna take the beating like the little whores we are.
Yeah, I don't really want to show that. Can we please cut to something else?
Oh, we have? Okay, good. I'm not gonna narrate. I'm gonna just let the story play out.
And that's why I think M&Ms are better than Skittles. Now, do you agree with me or not?
Nay, Donny.
Listen here, you skullish.
Was that the wee lad Stepney?
Help!
God, he's headed straight towards the yard. Point!
Oh God, here comes the crash!
Alright, who woke me up? This better be good.
Oh, for the love of God, Daisy, so help me, Lord.
Edward, right now is not really the best time to scold her.
Yeah, you're right. By the way, nice quick thinking.
Thanks. I am learning from the best, after all.
Is the wee engine okay?
I think one of us needs to check.
I don't know. I'm feeling a little out of it right now.
Alright, listen here, you lazy Scottish dubber.
Guys, Stepney vanished.
Oh, well then, I'll let you all agree. What's even going on anymore?
Later.
Ah, there's dumbass number 1 and 5. Tell me, how did that beautiful little beating I tried to warn the both of you about go? We stood there and we took it. That's what I thought. Now how about we go off and go find some sheds-
OH MY GOD!
Holy shit, the bridge collapsed! How did that even happen? I think that was our first warning for screwing up. Let's go find some sheds, and tomorrow, you know where we go.
You bet I do.
What the fuck does he mean by first warning? What the fuck's even happening anymore? You know what, Neville? Yeah, trust me, that's what I'm asking myself. You know what? No, let me try to continue this on more of a high note. Okay.
Later that night, Edward was just looking out to the sea with Arthur.
Ah, I can see why you wanted to come out here. The view out here is beautiful. But really, what did you want to come out here and talk to me about? You don't really look that well.
Well, it's just... Do you actually think Thomas, Percy, and James are actually going to be able to save the island?
Don't you dare doubt them in the slightest. I've known those three since I've started working here, and let me tell you something. No matter how many escapades those three can go through, they always find out a way to come out on top. Even if it does have something to do with their own home. So don't worry your little smoke box. I know they'll come out on top. They usually do.
Well then, thank you for the reassurance. I really needed to hear that.
No problem, Arthur. I mean, hey, I'm always out here trying to help another engine, you know, making sure they're okay at least. I mean, literally asking anyone if they're okay is the least you can do. And hell, being for them is...
Well, I have grand news. The plan is working flawlessly.
Of course, this is one of the boss's plans. This was gonna work flawlessly.
Of course, but unfortunately, we still have little adventurers to deal with.
Of course, boss already has them handled, but since we attack tomorrow morning, where should we strike first?
Well, as a grand man did once say, the heart, D2. First, we attack the heart!
Alright then, that was completely unnecessary.
Yeah, I think I just need some sleep.
Alright boys, you've had a long enough nap, time for the both of you to wake up.
And don't even think about complaining, you know why I'm doing this. Yesterday was a fluke, but today we are doing this right. So who's with me? Yeah, you know what, yeah, let's do this, come on.
You good? Sounds like something's on your mind.
Yeah, nah, I'm fine, I promise.
If you say so. Anyway, let's get going, haha!
That's the spirit, gentlemen! Now, without further ado, how about we go save this island, you awesome mother-
Ah, you know, just to think of it.
Everything's soon about to be back to normal. It's remarkable, really. I mean, yeah, yesterday was a bit of a hiccup, but today's a new day, and I think everything's just gonna go smoothly from here on out.
My wine binges!
Me and my big fucking mouth.
Attention, dumbasses of Solor. We're here to kidnap and probably probe you. And if you do not come quietly, we will use tentacle force.
Toby, I'm gonna make a run for it.
Wait, hang on, but what about the other Diesels?
I'll lead them away. See you on the other side, box cab.
See you, Lemonheads. Catch you later, Chuckle Nuts.
Oi, D2! The bastard cut us off!
Then what are you two doing just standing here?
After him!
And then, apparently with a snap of a rod, my crank pinnet came loose and my side rod went through my run.
Edward, you good?
Yeah. It's just, you might need to get out of here.
Hang on, wait, what do you mean get out of here? Where do I even go?
Very minimal time to explain, but all I have to say is just go behind that for chance.
Alright, fine.
Come on, D2, I know you're out here.
D261, good to see you again. How have you been exactly?
Old man, quit with the small talk. I'd just kill you right here, right now.
Oh, please, with what? A little shunt? It's gonna take a lot more than that to take down this old dog. Okay, yep, that one ought to do it.
Glad to know you and I have the same.
Well, hey, look on the bright side. At least we're going down together.
Wait, what? Oh my god. Edward, no. Excuse me for being fashionably late. I hope I didn't miss anything. No, not at all. But please tell me you did bring a good fight. Alright, stop me if you heard this one. How about two Lemonhead Diesels named Harry and Bert?
Ah, yes, the best of the best. Let's kick some Diesel ass!
Sorry for being late. That was a nightmare. So, what did I miss?
Not much. Just start rounding up everyone here before boss gets here.
Alright then.
Thomas, James, Percy, wherever you three are with that coach, you better hurry the hell up!
Well, Albert's gonna leave off on that note. I guess I can just continue the story, considering, well, again, it's still about the three of us, so, roll it!
Alright, gentlemen, this is it. Today, we save our home as a team, because we're going right into that ironworks, and we're stealing that coach! Any further questions? And as the leader of this ragtag of adventurers, I say I go in first.
Oh, I'm not surprised. You know, it wouldn't kill you to let us take the lead for once.
Oh, you ain't fooling anybody. Why would you want to go in there? We'll ruin your precious paying work.
Oh, what was that, you little runt?
Yes, oh, I am really? You want to call me the runt?
And also, the one you my paying work means very much to me, you little precious. Green.
All right, the both of you, calm down. Percy! You know, it's not really nice to talk about James behind his tender. And James, speaking of you, Percy's got a point. You would literally cower out there the second you got a little bit of black smudge on your paint. Now, if you excuse me, I have an ironworks to charge into.
All right, Brighton. Now is the point of no return.
Oh, great, it's you!
What are you even doing here? I thought you were stuck in that barge back in 2000! What the fuck was that? Aw, you really think you're gonna scare me with a fake whistle? Please. Okay, enough of the silent treatment. I want some answers. Nom 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 nom! So much nope! While yes, I'm very aware it's very outlandish, but just stick with me here. What if Yuri has a few to come? Nobody, nope, 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 no, no, no! Jesus hell, Blue Boy, calm the hell down, where's the fire? There is a demon in that scrapyard! There is something that crawled out of hell! Okay, he's lost it. James, you go check it out. Bitch, I am the definition of swag! Really think I'm going in there? You go in there! Fine, you egotistical fuck! I'll go in there myself. Seems about normal. I mean, nothing too spooky at least. What was Thomas talking about? Looks like there's just two little scrap engines here. Yep, nothing weird about these two little engine corpses. Nothing at all. What in the Billy Bob Biscuit fuck is that thing?! Oh god, oh god, oh god, help, 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 please, 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 I beg of the Lord, please, 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 please! And don't even think about coming back, you overcooked, rusty, horn hog of a wiener! Hey, look, the coach. Bluey, little help here? Oh yeah, hey, Rusty Cock, how about you get your damn buffers off my best friend before you won't have any cock to speak of? Alright, now, Percy, get the hell out of here. I'll deal with him myself. Oh, no need to tell me twice. Hey, look on the bright side. At least we found the coach. But where's James at? Simple. He's right behind you. Percy, if I were you, I would look out. Looks like it might be still after you. Wait, what was that? Oh, come on, man! Oh, God, no! Help, 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 help. Percy, hang on, I'm coming. Right after I deal with you, of course. Shit, he's bringing out the claw. You got any ideas?
You thinking what I'm thinking?
That could be a big possibility.
Coach for
question remains, how the hell do I get you out of here?
There you are, it's about time you showed up.
Well, they do say better late than never, correct?
Good one. Alright, let's get the hell out of here.
Sorry, I would love to stay and chat, but that looks like my cue to leave.
That's it? This is how bleak it all is? Well, we got ambushed. The hell were you expecting? A happy ending? This isn't a fairy tale, Henry. This is real life, and we've got to learn to accept that.
Yeah, I know life isn't a fairy tale. You don't need to remind me. It's just I needed to know if everyone was okay, alright? Just please!
Wait, what? Who's out there? Show yourself! Oh, Arthur, it's you. Say, where's Edward? I know he was last seen with you. Oh, I am so sorry. I had no clue. Oh my god. Well, maybe it's best for you to possibly come with us. I mean, hey, what else have we really got to lose, right?
Well, I guess on that somber note, it's best if I just end the story. Alright, you know what? I'm gonna let events play out. Just roll it.
And I swear to all that is living, if I see him again, I will... Hey, Thomas? Are you alright?
Yeah, I'm fine. It's just... I'm really glad you were here to help us succeed.
Glad to be part of the adventure.
Glad to have you on said adventure. Hello, my dear friends. I hope I didn't miss too much. It's not much. Me and James were just talking before he was going off to sleep. Alright then. Well, if you don't mind me asking, what do I do with this coach for now? For now, if you have a place, I say put it somewhere very safe. We'll just tell everyone the good news, then we can grab it, and then we can fix this whole situation. Alright then, you're the boss. I'll let you go off to sleep now. We've had a long day.
Good night, Percy.
Night, Thomas. And as for you, my little friend, I know exactly where to put you.
What the hell?!
Okay, I'm gonna try not to scare you guys, but please just listen to me. Apparently there was this huge earthquake last night, and... It's best if you just look at each other, maybe, and then you'll see what I'm talking about. Alright then, point taken. Maybe it's best for us to stop waiting around, and maybe we should get going.
I do have to agree, but Percy, where the hell is that coach?
Oh, James, for the love of God, don't start now!
If you're going to ask, I've been looking all over, but I've found no one yet. But maybe it's best if we look as a team.
I won't argue with that statement. But before we leave, Percy, do you know where the coach is? I'll tell you on the way. Alright then. And James, are you on board? Fine. Boko, lead the way. Alright then. Boko, you know what to do.
I will lead the way then.
So
So, guys, is it just me, or does this place look a little... what's the word?
Barren? Yes, but we don't know if that's fully the case yet. Let's split up.
Alright, you and I will go looking down the main line. James, Percy, go down the little western route.
Alright then, but here's the thing. How do we know if anyone actually is still alive, genius?
James, come on, just have a little faith for once in your life.
Ugh, fine, but I still think this is bullshit.
Won't you look at that? Dead in the sheds is still in one piece. How funny. Wait, hang on. Are those?
Well, well, well. Welcome to the Resistance, boys.
What?
You might need to sit in those rolling stock sidings. You two have missed a lot.
Meanwhile...
Whoa, whoa, whoa! Careful there, fat boiler! You're gonna make the whole track cave in!
Huh? What'd you say, James? It's just I have a lot on my mind right now. Oh! Wow! Jesus Christ, James! What could you have possibly done to the bridge?
What the hell do you mean, what did I do? You know why this happened!
Oh, James, can you please shut the fuck up?
Sorry, boys, it looks like you're coming with us.
Oh, you dirty 060 sons of bitch.
And that's everything we know thus far? Unfortunately, yes, that's where we currently stand with all these events.
Well then. Boko, I guess we could say we truly did miss a lot in the last 2 days. Eh?
Sorry, Thomas. I just need time to clear my head.
Oh, well then, I'll just, let you be on your way then.
While I do appreciate the fact you've maintained your sense of humor, I need to ask, do you have any further questions?
Actually, yeah. You mentioned something about a resistance leader, so who is it exactly?
Yes, forgive me, I forgot to mention his identity. Well, you see...
Oh, here he comes now. That can't be who I think it is, right? Well, bust my boiler.
Well, I see I unfortunately missed Boko, but that doesn't matter right now. What does matter is I was able to deduce a location where Diesel 10 can be found and may be trapped. And Oliver, I want you to come with me.
Alright, I can see why, but what about the others?
It's best for us to maybe stay behind, just in case.
That's what I like about you, Gordon. You're always thinking ahead of time. Now, Oliver, what do you say? You in or out?
You can count me in, Commander.
Alright then. And by the way, Thomas, you should stay with these guys. No offense, I don't really trust you in a battlefield right now. You're quite inexperienced.
Understandable, Commander. I'll stay right here.
Alright then. Oliver, let's go kick some diesel. Alright, this is the only place I've deduced. They can't be anywhere but here.
You know, I'm not doubting your word, but don't you think it's taking a while?
Give it time, Oliver. He'll show up eventually.
Come on, Oliver, kick his ass.
Henry, you're gonna need to launch out a lot of steam if we're gonna want one of his fuses to overheat.
Oh dear lord, Oliver, you need to get the hell out of here now!
Wait, hang on, what about
you.
I said now!
Fine, fine, but just cool your pistons.
What the fuck was that all about? I have no idea, but maybe it's best for all of us to go do a search, just in case to see if everyone's alright.
Whoa. What the hell was that?
Oh man, what the fuck?
Well, Gordon, we looked all over Old Harbor, but we couldn't find any signs of them. I'm sorry, but really, with Oliver and Henry gone, I think we have no choice but to turn back.
No, Thomas. Please, just shut your mouth for a second and just listen. You and I have the will and power to save this island, and we made an alliance to prove that fact. Now, are you with me or not?
Damn. Now that you bring up the whole alliance thing, let me think about this for a minute. Fuck it, I'm in.
That's the spirit, my dear engine! Well, here we are. The point of no return. My question is, are you ready?
Bitch, you know I was born ready!
That's a good engine.
And then apparently my driver was so incompetent and the whole damn pot blew up.
Excuse them there, idiots. If you want an update on the situation, we lost Sydney in that little complication with Henry and Oliver. Oh, you have to be kidding me.
Hang on, wait a minute. That's Gordon and Thomas!
We're saved!
Oh, fuck. Attention, dumbass diesels. We have come here to take something back that is ours. I'm gonna need my friends in that coach. And if you don't give them back right now, I will completely smash you down and turn you into a can of tuba for it. And I will make sure that you go-
No, Thomas, stop.
Yeah, Gordon, what's up? I'm just trying to intimidate these guys.
You were at a good point, but now it's just sad.
Damn it, yeah, you're right. Alright, you finish the job.
Well, you tried. You tried. Excuse him, he really didn't prepare for this anyway. He has a point. Just let the two engines and the coach back.
Aaron, Bert, get rid of Gordon, why don't ya?
Thomas, you take care of Splatter. Aaron and Bert.
Yes, sir! Oh, come on, Bert. Do something!
Clever bastard.
You taught him that, didn't you?
That is a huge possibility.
Now that gives me an idea.
Okay, before you go chatting up later, I should mention Percy is... How do I say this? He's escaping.
Then what are you keeping me here for? Get out of the way! I don't see him anywhere. Wait.
Come one, come all, before your very eyes, the dumbest diesel known to planet Earth.
Ah, clever idea, Thomas. Oh!
Thomas, look out!
Wait, what?
Motherfucker!
Oh, you're going to die for that!
That was for Bert, you son of a bitch! Oh, come on!
Okay, listen here, you giant yellow brick.
Okay, Percy, I don't want any arguments, so you're just gonna have to shut up and listen to me. Now, while Gordon's distracting Diesel 10, I need you to get the hell out of here and run as far as you can. Got it?
But what if I...
No buts! You get out of here with your life. I'll be fine, okay?
All right, fine, I guess.
No, Percy, you forgot the card!
I've been doing this all that night.
Now, with all of that out of the way, just give me, James, Percy, and that coach, and no one gets hurt. That's what I thought. Alright, fine. No need to honk all angry about it.
Come on, think of something. Where can you hide? Where can you even run at this point?
All right, that's enough thinking. Maybe it's best if I just keep running. They should be here at any minute. I think we just need to give it to Gordon and James straight. No bluffing, no sugarcoating. We just give it to them straight.
Percy, it's amazing to see you! Where are the others?
Oh, they bit the dust, didn't they?
What do we do? What do we do?
Hey, Percy! How'd you holding up? Still having the silent treatment, eh? Oh,
well, I wish I had more to say. But I can't! I'm an optimist, but I'm also a realist.
Right, Becca, come along. We don't have all day. We've only got limited resources and we need to find them.
Coming, Arthur! See you soon. Okay, Percy?
never came back, but I guess that's not really a surprise to you, huh? Alright, well, I guess I can give you a basic rundown. Well, after doing a bit of digging, I figured out it's just me, the coach, and that goddamn Diesel. And, well, I have really nowhere else to turn at this point. Our supplies is quite low, and I've got only enough coal and water to last me through the next couple of days, but at this point, I'm tired of running. I'm tired of running and hiding, waiting for someone to save me. I have a plan, and tonight it will be executed. I'm gonna save this goddamn island. I promised my home that I would save it, and tonight it comes to fruition. Sodor, be prepared. I'm gonna save you all.
Alright, here you are.
Now the question remains with you. How do I get you out of here without being seen?
Oh, fantastic! It's you! You've got a lot of nerve showing up!
And you got a lot of nerve showing up here. Now, what exactly do you plan on doing with that coach?
Oh, well, so you can talk. Well, guess what? What I'm doing with this coach is completely classified.
Yeah, yeah, what's it to you that I can talk? Now listen, how about you get to talking about that coach? Or else you're gonna have a giant hole left by you know who.
No, I would make fun of you for talking to an inanimate object, but I think I've gotta go.
So if that's how you wanna play it, huh? I'm game then.
This thing gets so heavy. I don't remember it being this heavy. Come on, where's that signal box where I need to put you? There you are!
Throughout this week, fate's been written. Just cause Percy couldn't listen. Time is March, now you're here with me. I'm the last you'll ever see!
Hey, Diesel! You wanna know what's even cooler than trying to destroy me and my world?
Magic.
No, wait, I beg you, wait!
Oh, am I dead? Oh.
That should hold you still for now.
You're the
Yes, Percy. It's me. And I want to deeply thank you for your effort to save Zion.
Thank you, ma'am. I've heard about all your escapades, especially with the Marklin.
Too bad the bloody bastard left a month ago on a holiday and didn't even give us a note.
Trust me, I do regret having this help sometimes. But back on to topic. Is there anything else you want me to say before I fix all of this?
Yes, actually. Thank you. Thank you for everything today.
You're very welcome.
You know, I've been wanting payback for some time. Jesus, good lordy, mother of God!
Alright, Lazy Wheels, you've had your nap for long enough. Now, how about we get going? There's a party down there at Tidmouth for us. And, I wouldn't want to keep them waiting any longer.
Alright then, I'll be there soon.
I guess I did really alright for a little goofball.
And that apparently dumbass cooked it for so long the churro exploded in his hands.
Splatter? That makes no sense whatsoever.
Man, why the fuck do I even talk to you?
Excuse me for being a bit fashionably late. I had to wake up a little green you-know-who.
I'm guessing by that reaction he took it well.
Hello, my fair gentleman. About time I make it here. So, what'd I miss?
Well, Percy, thanks to your ditch efforts, apparently, you've saved everything. And we're going to end the paper, apparently, as far as I've heard, at least.
Good news you bring that up, because I'm gonna need a good photo of you three now. If you could just look over here, please.
Alright, gentlemen. Smile for the camera now.
I just can't believe it, you two. We saved the world.
Wait a minute, you still owe me that new can of paint!
You motherfu-
It's Thomas the Tank Engine, hip 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 hooray! Chugga chugga chug chug chuff chuff chuff, he rides along the way. And when you hear that whistle, it can only be one train. Our favorite little engine, Thomas is his name.
Interesting. Very interesting indeed.